Whoa, getting off to a rocky start. Shalom, everyone. I am J.A. Dudley, heading home from some training with my brothers. And I was thinking about my truck driving career and then the little adventure I went on going to California, from here in Oklahoma to New Mexico, then driving across Arizona to California and then back. How that feels with being away from my family. I don't like being away from my family. My wife and children, my newborn son, because my other son that is older still lives in New Jersey, unfortunately, trying to get him out here as soon as possible. But I can't stand being away from my wife for very long periods of time. It was extremely rough while I was a over-the-road truck driver, being thousands of miles away. And if there was a problem or something like that, and I knew that at the minimum I was 2 to 3 days away from being back in her arms, or if she needed something, she needed to go somewhere. Even though she was able to do things on her own, it always felt weird or strange being that far apart. Like, it was almost like a world away. And so most of the time she would be out on the truck with me. That made things so much better, so much more convenient. I wasn't panicking, looking at the clock, wondering, well, can I drive this many hours today to get to this place, to get here, to try and get to my delivery a day early or hours earlier, try and rush in, rush out so I can hurry up and get back. It was a very stressful situation where it was not good for my mental health, and it wasn't good for her mental health as well, because I'm on the road. Stupid people on the road would piss me off. That would raise my road rage up through the roof. And I was not being who I'm supposed to be, the calm, respectful person. I looked forward to running people off the road, and that was only because there were people standing in between me and my wife. So whatever they were doing, whether it was intentional or not, I didn't want to have to I didn't want to have to rationalize what I was doing driving with them impeding me from getting back home. So I had to eliminate them. It was never a good day or a good feeling after doing stuff, but I was always able to sleep clear at night when all that I was worrying about was getting back home. So now, most recently I went out to California. Yeah, I had to go behind those enemy lines and retrieve a vehicle. So while doing that, it was the first time in a very long time that I was away from my wife for multiple days. And this was the first time ever that I've been away from my newborn son for more than a day. I think at the most I was away once overnight. And now doing that, it was very very emotional being out on the road. But thanks to technology like this, being able to FaceTime him, it put me at ease and seemed to put him at ease, because my wife would watch some of my YouTube videos. He'd get so excited, but then would look for me, look at the doorway, listening to me on YouTube, but looking for me to walk through the door. And she was able to tell that he was getting mentally frustrated with me not being there. So hearing that, seeing that over camera, it was It was something that I wouldn't necessarily want to do again. Granted, there are going to be times that I'm going to need to be away or go handle something, do a trip, do training, a whole bunch of different things. But that was a definite strainer on and pulling on my heartstrings from dealing with being away from him and my wife. But with my wife, we know we can talk to each other all the time as long as I have some type of cell phone signal. But I made sure to that my InReach was charged. Like when we were in New Mexico shooting, I was on top of a mountain with no cell phone service, so I was able to message her from my InReach, put her at ease, especially if she hadn't heard from me in multiple hours, wondering where I'm at, what I'm doing, why I'm not responding to messages. And that was a way for her to keep calm, a way for me to keep calm, to be able to still communicate. Granted, we weren't able to see each other over InReach, but it made do, because that was something that I was able to implement while being a truck driver. Her knowing exactly where I'm going to be at, but there not be a cell any cell phone service out there, and she would be put at ease as soon as she would get that InReach message. So that's pretty much it. Like, there's being away from home sucks. I'm glad that I was able to turn in my keys from being an over-the-road truck driver. It's a hustle and a grind that's still there and available if need be. But I don't plan on anytime soon going back to that lifestyle, because it definitely is a strain. Maybe when our son is older and sorry about that. My phone started overheating in the middle of recording. Hopefully everything at the end of the last bit of that segment was able to record. But I'm on the way home to go hug and kiss my wife and son, because I was left out early this morning to go do some CQB training with my brothers. Got all nice and sweaty. Then I have a few more things I need to get done around the house. And that's pretty much it. Hopefully you all understand and can understand being away from your family and how important it is to get back to them. I had to roll down the windows to cool everything off, so hopefully it's not too loud as I'm driving down these bumpy country roads. And shalom.